let's talk about postmenopausal bleeding today. Menopause is when someone has not got her periods for more than 1 year. Now, any bleeding that happens after that is called postmenopausal bleeding and should not be ignored. Such bleeding should be evaluated by the gynecologist. So when someone comes to us with bleeding after 1 year of cessation of periods, initially we examine her. Initially we look at the mouth of the uterus or cervix to make sure there is no cancerous growth coming from the cervix. Then the next evaluation will be to do an ultrasound. In ultrasound, we specifically look at the thickness of the inner lining of the uterus, because if there is uterine or endometrial cancer, the thickness of the inner lining will be more. We also check for the ovary. Sometimes there are some ovarian tumors or cancers which can secrete hormones which can cause bleeding after cessation of the periods. Now, though only 10% of cases may have cancerous lesion in the uterus when they have bleeding like this, 90% are non-cancerous causes. We need to evaluate them. So in the ultrasound, if the inner lining is less than 3 millimeter, usually it is not a cancerous cause, but any thickness which is more will have to be evaluated. So your gynecologist may suggest biopsy. The biopsy can sometimes be done on an outpatient basis, what we call as papal endometrial biopsy, or what's considered gold standard is to actually take a camera inside the uterus. This procedure is called hysteroscopy, where through the vagina a telescope is taken inside the uterus and the entire uterine cavity is evaluated, and we'll actually know what is the specific cause for this bleeding. Sometimes it could be that the lining of the uterus is bald, what we call as atrophic, or sometimes we can see a non-cancerous growth like a polyp or a fibroid, which is the cause of the bleeding, or there could be sometimes a suspicious growth. So when we look into the uterine cavity with a hysteroscope, we actually know what could be the probable cause, and many times we end up treating the cause itself. For example, if it's a polyp or a myoma, it can be removed at the same sitting itself, which will also become the treatment for the postmenopausal bleeding. So that becomes a gold standard way of evaluating anybody with postmenopausal bleeding. So important thing over here is not to ignore this symptom and approach your gynecologist at the earliest.